What? Hey! Can you fit that in the frame?
Lift him in by the mouth. Keep an eye on your mate, Jimmy. Don't let him.
He's got a big fish, but they're still quite eight.
Oh! What have you done?
Hey, fishing fans, it's Matt Watson here, and I'm introducing another of our feature length episodes. It is part two of the Ultimate Cup, which is teetering. Dean Barker is off to a massive lead.
That's how we like to get on the board, mate. Yes.
And of course, being a New Zealander, I'm doing as much as I can to help see Dean through. But we're about to experience the best fishing we've had. And just like the Fighting Australian, who's representing the United States, Jimmy Spittle, you'd expect, he is making a big fighting comeback.
Well, there you go, Dino. No one for the scoreboard, mate. Just the slow comeback. Here it comes.
This is an exciting one, and it's also incredibly fun, and there's loads of fish, so enjoy.
This week, we have the finale of the much-anticipated rematch between America's Cup rivals Dean Barker and Jimmy Spittle. This time though, the stakes are much higher. Fishing is three times more popular than sailing, and thus the battle for fishing's ultimate cup will once and for all settle the score.
Yeah, we got it.
Oh, I can feel that momentum. Can you guys feel that?
Yeah.
Little wave building.
Jimmy started the competition with a disaster. An undersized snapper cost him a two-point penalty.
That's actually illegal. And I'll check the rules, but I think that might be minus 2 points.
Not again.
Meanwhile, Dean was hooking up the fish and racking up the points in the 1-9 Ultimate Cup final.
Oh, sweet.
But just before the close of the first day of competition, a momentum shift. Jimmy hooked into the biggest fish of the competition, but it wasn't without controversy.
There is a time limit on...
It's work as a team, eh?
Look, I'm impartial.
You're meant to be helping.
So here we are with the scores at Team Barker 5, Team Spittle minus 1. But Jimmy has finally found some fish and found some form.
Well, there you go, Dino. No one for the scoreboard, mate. Just the slow comeback. Here it comes.
Nice. Okey-doke. Time for the grinder to step in. There you go, mate.
No worries.
Thumb on there, all the way to the bottom. Just
copy.
Just copy what your skipper did. Except you might want to get it in faster.
The going down part seems quite easy.
I'll just, while you're doing your thing over there, I'm just going to test out some of this Team New Zealand technology over here and drop it down. See how it goes, you know. Oh, there's three baits on this one. That's interesting.
Was that allowed in the rules, Matt?
I think that's legal. Come on, mate, eyes off.
Not looking. Wasn't even looking. Got a shot of that anyway. The drone got that.
Is it true that you guys had some dudes over in New Zealand taking photos when Team New Zealand, does that happen? Is that kosher?
No, all the time. The only rule is you're not allowed to sort of send choppers up, and you're not allowed to send anything in the air, and you've got to be 200 metres away. It'd be like you having someone, like your competition, just 200 metres away wherever you go.
Yeah. I love that joke.
That guy, he's inside 200 too, so.
Yeah. I should be winching a protest flag up. Get the lawyers out.
Hey, this is still going down.
Yeah, no, it's the whole idea.
I think we've got to like 2.5 km of line down now.
Yeah, it comes up real easy, mate.
Probably a couple of feet off the bottom, is that too much?
Nah, it's good. You should be right in amongst them, you.
Oh yeah, I'm on.
Here you go, there he goes, good boy.
Oh, sheep.
He'll get into the ground, wind down the line and just pull on low angles. Don't lift the flat part of the rod beyond horizontal. So wind down and lift it low.
Oh, he's taking line out.
Okay, you got 9.5 minutes, mate. Let's go.
He's taking line. I got a bit back there. Yeah. Mate, can you whack one on?
What, a gimbal bow?
Yeah. Would it be all right?
Really?
No, he's having a bit of a kick there. Good fight.
You're sitting down, you're in the game chair now.
The old Ishii Tech game chair.
The rules change, are they?
Yeah.
Thanks, Ishii Tech. Now, just for the folks at home, I'm pulling up from 600 metres.
That's
and
or 270.
All right, mate, keep it going. Don't give up.
I might winch that up now. Yeah, I've got a fish on there. Doesn't seem fair, eh, that you got to do all that work and I just push a button?
Really? You see him here, mate?
Nah, nothing, mate. Oh, yeah, we can actually. Getting close, Matty.
Oh, so hang on, I'm busy pulling my fish.
Still got your hands full.
I've got my hands full fighting this fish.
Mate, that's what us grinders are for. You're out of a job otherwise, Matty.
Oh, mate, that's a nice one.
Oh. I don't think it's that bad.
Blue nose, nothing wrong with that, mate. Well done.
Beautiful.
Another nice blue nose. Way to go. Way to go. Nothing wrong with that one, mate. Nice. Nothing wrong with that one. Well done.
Trouble is when you're as strong as I am, you make it look easy.
Yeah, it's just a little smaller, isn't it? But still a good one.
Yeah, still a good one, mate. Nothing wrong with that. Well
done, boys.
That's a lovely
fish. Just nice probably, job, mate. Probably a few centimetres bigger than Jimmy's. A lot harder to fight. Come up from a lot deeper. That's a nice fish, eh?
The 81 centimetre blue nose comfortably beats Team Barker's fish of just 62 centimetres. And that's another point registered for Team Spittle, taking the score to 5-0.
Hey, look at this. I think I've got your pip there, boy.
That's a nice size fish, though.
That
well done.
Awesome. Awesome.
Well done.
Awesome.
More points on the board.
Yeah.
Yes.
Here we come.
Oh, it is a bass. Little baby bass. There you go, there's another species.
You're beautiful looking.
Oh, look at that. He got away, but I caught him with my hands. Look at that.
Oh, you're amazing.
Noodled him.
Yeah,
there you go, bass. That's just a neat. Yeah, they're a real neat fish, very similar to the harp hooker. And these are the guys that grow, like they get up to sort of 90 kilos even.
Wow,
I've seen them come out of this spot at 77 kilos.
That's just a baby.
Yeah, it is. And just beautiful flesh. No size limit on these guys because normally when you pull them up out of the depth, they're buggered, you can't release them.
Right,
that makes sense. And that's just gonna make fantastic eating as well.
Beautiful.
Beauty, little cutie. We've got a whole power of fish there. So there's probably not much more point us doing any more deep drops. So how about we mix it up? I've got to clean up all that fish and they'll prepare it for us at Kingfish Lodge tonight.
Awesome.
And while I'm preparing it, we might as well have some lures out. We might catch a marlin. If we catch some skipjack tuna, we can try live baiting and we could use the tuna for snapper bait tomorrow.
Awesome,
perfect,
mate.
Let's do it. Let's go for
another species. Sweet as, yeah. Sweet
love
as.
It.
Nice plan, Jimmy. I like
teamwork, guys.
I like your thinking. I like your thinking, man.
Just trying to take a bit of leadership out here.
In the New Zealand summer, the big game fish arrive on our shores. And like any predatory fish, you'll find them wherever you find their food.
There's another couple of bait balls here on the finder.
Yeah, if we can catch a couple of skippies, we're going for a real good shot here.
At the moment, the bait fish is skipjack tuna, a favourite food of marlin, so they're the perfect live bait. But they're also a good eating fish. So right now for Team Spittle, just catching one could deliver another much needed point.
Here we go, slow us down, we've got two on. Okay, there you go, Jimmy.
Thanks, bro.
Hopefully the bait that's going to catch us out swimming. Woo-hoo! Marlin, I've had it happen quite often when you're trying to pull these things in, the marlin comes and eats them. You can wind that marlin lure in, please, mate.
Yes, no worries.
Hey, I'm just winching mine in. Big skippy, beautiful fish. Jeez, he's a monster. He's a monster skippy. That's a bloody donk of a skip. Okay.
Here we go, a bit of colour here too.
Okay, he's going to splash Dave, so he's going to be careful, mate.
Woohoo!
Woohoo! Right, we've got us one live bait. I tell you what, as far as measuring skippies go, mate, this is about as big as they're going to blooming get for you. Now, what I want you to do when you swing this one in, okay, grab him by the tail and hang him upside down.
God, okay. How beautiful that fish is.
Oh, no, look at the colour on them, eh? And the blooming camera never ever does it justice. So you're lucky you're here firsthand to see those colours. Well, that's the same colour as a marlin.
Wouldn't that make a lovely pair of slippers for Dean?
Enough of the cheap shots, just measure the tuna. We have got 52. Slowly arc us around, we want to be heading back in. Aaron. Okay, this bait's going in the water in a couple of seconds.
Got him, Mike?
Yeah, I got him. Right, and that there, if something eats that, we are in serious business. Right, mate, I'm happy with a bait like that out.
Be nice just to end the day with a little marlin, wouldn't it? You know, like we've been able to hit quite a few species today. We've got some really good fish. We'll just top off a fantastic day. A little bit of breeze has kicked in, nice little sea breeze. And yeah, just be the icing on the cake, wouldn't it? You never know.
Looking good, we just need our fish to bite. And we are in business. Well, unless we get a bite in the next 30 seconds, might have missed out on our marlin for today, Jimmy.
Mate, it's not over.
With time up on day one, Jimmy has missed out on catching his first marlin, but he has scored a point with his 52-centimetre tuna, continuing his comeback and taking the scores
on the
to Team Spittle 1, Team Barker 5. So with Team Spittle now feeling pretty happy about their strong finish to the day, we take them back to Kingfish Lodge, where they enjoy the catch of the day prepared by the chef. And while they're so comfortable and relaxed, we decide to leave them in the bar to celebrate late into the night.
Just goes to show you need a good skipper on your boat, eh? Things go terribly wrong when you got the wrong one.
Nice to see a couple more Aussies.
Oh, there must be Dean.
But as the day dawns on the final day of fishing in the Ultimate Cup, Team Spittle are nowhere to be seen.
Those Team Oracle boys obviously in no hurry, and they perhaps don't understand the early bird gets the worm theory with fishing. Wind's getting up too.
Perhaps Jimmy is so confident of his comeback abilities, he can afford to sleep in. But for Dean's last day, he's taking nothing for granted.
The forecast is getting better and better. We've got the model again this morning, instead of it just drops away.
Well, we're navigating our way out by radar this morning because these guys are keen and they've got us up early. It's not the ideal time of the year to be trying to catch the fish that we're trying to catch today, but got full confidence in you fellas.
It's a good thing we have the grinder here, eh, for this one.
We'll get out there, so know where the safety gear is. Plenty of life jackets on board if you want one, if you guys want one. There's something funny if you need them, and if there's no further questions, make sure your tray table's stowed away, your seat back is upright. Okay, when you're ready, go, go, go. Well, here we're dropping in 300 metres of water, so you've got a long way to go there, Dean. And our main eating fish that we're likely to encounter out here are our gemfish, bluenose, harp hooker, and bass. And pretty challenging conditions, we're fishing with just one rod.
Yep, some bites.
There we go. Well, Dean, it appears you've got a fish on there. Once again, it's taken Dean all of about, maybe 20 seconds that time. You're slipping, mate. Feel free to use the electric button if you want. I know you're not used to having a button at your disposal. And enjoy. Hopefully it's not a shark, and hopefully it's an eating variety.
This is the first time I've ever fished in water anywhere near like this, Dean. Yeah, it's going to be interesting to see what we pull up today. It's nice having technology on your side, I have to say. It's got to make sure we don't run out of juice.
Oh, we won't run out of juice. That's because we've got the big X-Side batteries. That's a good throw to one of our sponsors there, Dean. Thank you for that. And it's a good point, actually. We're a long way out at sea. It's not like we can pull over on the side of the road and get a jump start. So we've actually got four batteries on here, two start batteries and two big house batteries with a massive big reserve cap because out here you need good batteries, X-Side Starlights.
Going around the final mark.
25 metres now. What's it going to be?
Get one. It might be a gem. It might be a gem, hopefully. Might be a couple of gems. Oh, yes. Nice gemfish. Oh, is that a shark following it up? Oh, that's a beauty gemfish. Hey?
Push up with the teeth on that bugger. Okay, watch that one. And not just one gemfish, but two gemfish. That's a big gemmy, boy. Look at the teeth on those guys. Now, they are a cousin of the barracuda, but unlike the barracuda, these guys are good eating. But even bigger teeth than the barracudas, they're just like blades.
That'd definitely do some damage, wouldn't it?
Yeah, real delicate, delicate white flesh. Beautiful, like probably the best smoked fish you'll ever get. Oh, nice start, Dino. I'll take that off you.
I'll grab the measure.
Yep. 105. 105, I think that might do it for you in the gem fish department. Let's get that one, what's the bait, that same one up again, eh? Stand by to drop, fellas. Gotta close this out.
There's something had a go to then on.
Just give them a chance to eat it. Oh yeah, so lower your rod tip down when you're first getting your bites. Yeah, or that could be a bit of fish.
Yeah, some good bites.
Okay, give it a slow wind.
Yeah.
Your rod tip.
Yeah, it's on there.
Because if it's a bass, you've got to work them away from the bottom. Doesn't look like a bass though. It's rat gem fish again, I think. Heave them up, Dean. Heave them up.
Rightio, time for the technology. Nice if it's a little armchair to sit in, wouldn't it?
120 metres to go.
Loving it.
15 metres.
Some colour. Here they come.
That's not stopping.
Oop. Yeah, that one.
That's not stopping.
Gems. Three gems.
Three hooks, three gems.
Oh.
Woo. And one whopper.
Oh, one of them's four. A beast. Oh. Okay.
Woo.
Bring it home, Dean. Bring it home. That is a beast of it.
That's
look
a
how
whopper.
Deep he is. That's a big gem fish here.
You got
big
three
one.
Of them. Well done.
This one's about 118.
This 118 centimetre gem fish is another point for Team Barker, and they now streak out to a 6-1 lead. And back at Kingfish Lodge after a night of premature celebration, it's now after 9:30 a.m. and Jimmy and Aaron have finally arisen, but still confident of completing their comeback, they seem in no hurry to get out on the water.
Jeez, mate, how's the cricket?
Mate, should we get another latte?
Yeah, I reckon.
Hey, lads, how you going?
So at last we get away from the dock and head out from Whangaroa Harbour to hunt for any eating fish that qualify for points in the Ultimate Cup.
Yeah, looks like a few kingies here and some, probably some mau mau at least.
Anyway, early days. Okie doke, we'll give it a crack here, right? Aaron, if you just want to drop this rig, live bait on top, bit of a bait on the bottom. And Jimmy, we'll get you working on this jig, eh? Have a little bit of a play with that. It'll take you a bit to get a sort of a feel for it. At the moment, it looks like we've got a bit of a front coming through, boys, and a bit of a squall. We're just going to tough it out.
New Zealand, mate. Give it 5 minutes.
Yeah. Looks like with this front coming through, guys, we might be reaching our upper wind limit. But we'll wait till you're hooked up before we decide whether it's too windy or not.
Not going to give up, man.
No, that's the way. Aaron, just bounce the bottom for a little bit. We're just coming over the ledge.
Oh, yeah, come on. Yeah, I got one here.
Hey. Nice and smooth, mate.
Yeah, good. I don't know.
Well, that's the thing, you know, and these were, like I was saying before, I've caught everything in this spot from snapper, hooker, kingfish to marlin. I'm picking it's not a marlin.
Yeah, and no, I've got that feeling too.
But it could be a potential scoring fish, so.
Oh, mate, yeah, points on the board.
Oh, mate, you know what that is?
What is it?
That there is a pink mau mau, and they are fantastic eating.
Beautiful, wow, look at that.
It's been a long time since we caught one of these,
mate,
on the show.
What a magnificent fish.
Yes, you get blue mau mau as well. These are a much more thick set fish, and you get better fillets off them. And we'll probably get Chef at Kingfish Lodge to sashimi this one for us tonight. And for the record, it is 35 centimetres long. And pretty hard to come by, so that could...
double points.
Oh, wow, it could be, mate. I'll just have to check those rules. I'll have to check those rules, mate.
I'm guessing it's another penalty, but anyway.
Just got hit on the way down then. That's always a good sign.
Get it down there, Jimmy.
Yep,
nice
got play. Him.
Where are we going?
Oh, it's a beauty, dude.
Oh, it's a better one.
Nice, Matty.
Oh, that's a good fish.
Okay, where should I go? 50, Matty?
You go to 60, mate. There's fish there. Try not to tangle me if you can help it.
There's a big lump at 62.
You generally get the bigger ones on the live baits. Oh, it's picked up your line. Bugger.
you might have my line, eh?
Yeah, the kingy swam around it. It's all right. Oh, I'm tangled. Hopefully he doesn't hook up. Come and grab this rod, someone, please. So we can sort this out. Oh, he's wrapped up pretty good.
Ready to feed it, or?
Hopefully your bait doesn't get eaten about now. It would not be good. Okay, away he goes. Get him out of the road.
Cool having an assist, eh?
Yeah.
I get half the points, because we all saw it. The camera doesn't lie. My line was wrapped around its little fin.
Does that sound like desperation to you at home? It sounds like...
Teamwork.
Oh, no, don't strike. Oh. Don't strike, it's a circle lock. Yeah, no. Even when he's on, there's still no strike with the live bait. Viewers of our show don't often get to see rookie mistakes. So
very rare to see what not to do.
So it's nice. It's, that's helpful, Jimmy. Oh, it's good. It's good
just
example.
Trying to grow the sport.
Oh, yeah, you're on. Yeah. Okay, you're going to use the rod, mate. Lift them, get them moving. Oh, that's a goodie, boy. Woo-hoo! Oh, don't lift too high. Just lift there. Drop and wind, get a wind. Okay, you never want to stale, mate. Okay, you're not on the pin. I'll make it easier for you. See, I'm looking after you, mate.
Good on
your
boat. Impartial, I love it.
Okay, nice and smooth. With a kingy, the smoother you can be, yeah, lift, use the rod to pull them in, drop and get a wind, there you go. Maybe not as big as I initially thought.
He took off with his new rod, didn't he?
Yeah. I wanted to take this bloody banana back, it's not working.
No, don't throw it in there.
Okay, neutral there. Easy, holy, now he fights. Okay, what I'm going to, if you back the drag, put the rod in the rod holder, I'm going to sling him straight into your arms for the pick.
Ready?
Yeah, got him.
Well done, mate.
Okay. You slimed, yep. Let's pop that circle lock out. It's got a rubber band rig on it. Get your picks. We'll get a measure of them. Yeah, it's not a bad fish. Yeah, it's not a bad one.
Okay. Just let me get a shot with the two, Jimmy. Yeah, that's it. Hold on, hold his head up a bit.
Okay, we'll get him on the mat. Flop that one over. And he is a 93. Not bad, mate. Not bad. Right, we'll send him home, eh?
Getting bigger and bigger. See you, mate.
Go straight towards Kane. Oh, nice. Ripped away. Hey, pretty good, well done, mate.
Nice, mate. Cheers,
yeah.
Mate.
Definitely a better day today.
Yep.
You saved it all for the final mate. Day.
Well done, son.
Nice driving, eh?
Good stuff. Yeah, yeah, well, it's always a driver, mate, you know that.
True to form, Jimmy has caught a kingfish that will be difficult for Dean to beat. Kingfish are tough to catch, and points in this section will be key to winning the ultimate cup. There's 2 points up for grabs, one for kingfish on a jig, and another for kingfish on a bait.
Well, it's just a little kingy, I think. There you go.
Nah, he's not a big one.
It's a practice one, mate, it's a practice, yeah.
I don't think he's a world beater.
Unless it's a snapper, in which case it'll be a nice one.
It's a snapper.
Oh, you beauty, leave him in the water. Right, I'll just get the net.
Well done.
No mucking around. We'll just get that. Hey, that's how we like to get on the board, mate. Yes.
That's nice.
That's how we like to do it. Hey. Yeah, as I was saying, we're not kingy fishing here. This is my secret snapper spot. Now, we've got to leave some things up for a little bit of a surprise. That's a bloody beauty, mate.
Nice fish.
I think we might have your PB for you there, Mr. Barker. Now, this one's come out of 100 metres of water, and you see we've been live baiting, but as we know with this spot in particular, these snappers are true predatory fish. Right, and that is
59 centimetres, which is a nice one. We're probably going to catch some more for a feed. Up to you, yeah.
No, put them back.
That's a great snapper for Dean, but we've already finished the snapper fishing section, so it won't score a point. The points now up for grabs are in the kingfish section or any of the other good eating fish found in the deep. So Dean has opted to drop a bait to the bottom while his grinder Wooly is trying to connect with a kingfish on a jig.
Getting bites down on the bottom there, Dean?
Yeah, just little ones, yep.
Yeah. You got him? Oh yes, well done, the baits. Everything the man touches.
Doesn't feel like a big fish though, unfortunately, but something.
Now it has to be an eating fish to count.
It's pretty small, whatever it is.
What do we got? What do we got?
Big terakee.
Terakee, is it?
Oh no!
Grab it, grab it, grab it, Kane, grab it! Oh no! That would have aced it!
Oh.
That would have been a monster to take those hooks.
A mix-up by the Team Barker crew, and potentially a vital point has gone begging. But Grinder Wooly is looking to make amends, so he rigs up and drops again.
Yep. Coming up?
Yeah.
Oh good, might be a terakee. That'd be awesome. So long as it's an eating fish. Getting any bites there, Dean?
Not yet.
That's all right, you're about to tag out with Wooly anyway, so do the switcheroo when you're ready. There we go, and Dean. It's a team effort. There's the latest state-of-the-art gear right there too. The Shimano Anarchy. What do we got? Hopefully something edible. Conditions are cutting up. We don't want the competition
Pink
called
meow
off.
Meow.
Pink Meow Meow, yep, that's an eater, boy. Get the net under him.
Yes.
Yes, sweet as. You beauty. Just grab him in the gills, yep. We'll get a measure on that guy. Yes. Pink Meow Meow. The pink Mau Mau, a fish we don't often catch because you need those small hooks. They live in deep water, a real delicate white flesh. And that one's coming home with us. Whenever I catch one of those, they always come home. Yeah, they're real good eating, man. Real good eating fish.
For Dean to score a point, his pink Mau Mau will have to beat the 35 centimetres recorded by Team Spittle.
Okay, we have got 37.
That's a crucial point for Team Barker, taking them to a commanding 7-1 lead. A big kingy on a jig and another on a live bait could now get Dean the two vital points he needs to take home the ultimate cup.
Yeah. Yep, Wooly's on. Oh, there's heaps down there.
Yep.
Put your drag up. Yeah, you got him. That's what we like to see, boys. We're doing it. We're working it. All right, Wooly, all clear. Might be a little kingy there, Dean. Oh, yep, hello. Hello, it's got a little bit of pull. There we go, that's a little bit better than me, mate.
Ah. Wooly,
nice grinding work there, Wooly. Yeah, we'll get the measuring mat out for this. Although I don't know how long it's gonna stand.
You're gonna beat it,
then. 91. The match officials can verify that. Yeah, straight over. Okay, and we'll move straight over. Just step backwards a little bit, Dean. Step back for us. Nice one.
Yes.
Nice one. Oh, we only just talked. I'll see if I can grab him in the mouth. There we go, you beauty. What we'll do is we'll just keep the wet rag over his eye, just and that'll help keep him calm. We have got stunt double, I think, 90 centimetres. If you put the head down a little and the tail up, the fish looks bigger. Don't know why, but it does. Works a treat every time. I'm looking at the sounder, and there's kingies right there. So, right, quickly, let them go, mate. That fish isn't big enough. There's fish under us right now. You can drop again right here. Got him. Heavier fish this one. It's gonna go in a sec. Doesn't know it's hooked yet. Just feels like a big heavy fish that isn't doing a heck of a lot yet.
Yeah.
Good one or? Oh, jeez. Oh, I just don't have as much drag as what Wooly's got on that 80 pound. Is yours an all right one, is it, Wooly?
No, it's come alive anyway.
Yeah, let it run, let it run. Okay, now push the drag up. Yeah, you got him, mate. It's a three-way! Every man for himself. Every man for himself. Oh man, this fish is still going. I can't stop him. Oh, there you go, it's a kingie. Just get a wrap on the line. Don't let the line slide through your hands because it'll cut you. So get a good wrap around your hands. Yeah, 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 and under your wing. There he goes. Okay, yeah, just wait. See, he was happy, he was wagging his tail. Nice work.
How'd you go? Jeez, it's a beauty.
There we go. I think that's gonna be a measure. I think we've just upgraded. Nice work. Nice fish, Wooly. Well done the grinder for Team Dean. 90, no, that's 92.
Brilliant.
It's another nice kingfish, but not big enough to score for Team Barker. And now, they're racing the clock, as they need two more points before the end of the day's fishing, or the ultimate cup will be declared a draw.
You're definitely milking this one, aren't you?
Yeah. I'll get you to hang on to that rod for a sec. Oh, he's heavy.
Oh, that's a better one.
Oh, look at that, and the hook come out. That's a big, heavy thumper. Look at that. He's a fatty.
Yeah, I'll get you to hang on to him just so you can feel how big he is. Heavy is if nothing else.
He's heavy, eh? Okay, and let him rip. Okay, Dean, you could do with another species. What about a bait?
Right, I'll try that. Yeah. There's colour here now.
What? Okay, right, it's all going on.
Another snapper. Where's the net?
Oh, it's another snapper. Get the net underneath them. It's only light line though, so.
Yeah, that one.
Oh, yes. Oh, that's a panty. Oh, Kingy's here. Here, Dean, come grab this jig rod, mate. But there's a few fish there, sort of in that 70.
Probably deep enough there, Dean, so flick that in gear.
There you go, he's a natural! Hey! One wind, mate. One wind, he's got one. Oh, yes. Now we're talking. If you just work your way towards the back a little bit, I'll be able to get into those helm controls. Yeah. Now we're going to want to get this one in before the wind gust gets too high.
Yep. Yeah, it could trigger any time.
Yeah.
That means hurry up, Dean.
I think we're pretty safe. I know the guy that owns the wind meter. I think the batteries went flat in it today. Oh, look at them go. See, after that long, it's amazing they can still run like that, eh?
Amazing, yeah.
They're an incredible fish, mate. They really are. You see the old technology we've invested in here, having the second screen, that paid for itself right there. Standing out here and I went, oh, there we go, there's some kingies, drop the jig. Boomfa.
Oh, there's some colour.
There we go.
Jesus, that's a big fish.
Oh yeah. Keep him coming in nice and smooth. He might be a bigger fish than what I thought he was. That's better than what I thought he was. Oh, he's still got go. Oh, don't make it anxious, just get him in now. Jeez, he's a nice one, boy. He's a big one. He's a big puppy, boy. It's a big one, eh?
Open your mouth, buddy.
Hey. Hey. Can you fit that in the frame?
What a fish.
What a fish, all right, boy.
Well done.
Well done, mate. Hey.
That is good.
Oh, it's another fat fish too. What a thumper. 110, 11, 12, 13, 113.5. With Swedish rounding or whatever they call it, I think that makes it 114. Yeah, we don't do things by halves, literally. Oh, hug him in. It's a thing of beauty.
How heavy would this one be, you reckon?
That one there's well over 25 kg.
How do you like this one, Jimmy?
Oh, beautiful. Couldn't have said it better myself. Okay, he's ready. Yep, let him rip. Powers away. That's what we like to see, mate.
114 centimetres is an excellent kingfish on a jig for Team Barker. And now that he's onto the big ones, Dean's looking to extend his advantage and catch a big one on a live bait.
There they are, kingies. Oh, good marks too.
Yep.
And you're away. Still wants to pull back, does it, eh? They tend to do that. Woohoo! It's got some boogie. Yeehaw.
Colour here now.
Okay.
Man, this guy's got some serious fight.
Oh, yes. What do you know? It's our old mate, the kingie.
Jesus, that's a big fish.
Oh, yes, it's another beauty. Just holy smokes, it's even bigger. It's even bigger. Okay, where's that lip gaff, Willie? Just get ready to back that drag off if he takes off. Holy smokes, it's even bigger, mate. Oh, it's gonna be a lift. Oh, boom! We even nailed the high fives!
Yeah.
We even nailed the high fives! Look at that beast!
That's a couple of excellent kingfish for Dean, and it could be the 2 points Team Barker needs to take the ultimate cup. But they can't celebrate yet. Jimmy can still make a miraculous comeback and better Dean's kingfish of 114 centimetres on a jig and 118 centimetres on a live bait. So with time almost up, Team Barker heads out to search for more eating fish in the deep, while Jimmy has gone for a big live bait as he attempts to catch the winning kingfish and continue his comeback run.
Go 60. Yeah, got him.
Got him!
Beginner's luck. Oi. Yeah. Double hooker.
Oh, woohoo! Go, boy!
Now, with any luck, my fine diameter braid should be able to cut through that mono. But if it does, it's an accident, okay? I can't control this fish. Just so you know, mate. Which way is your line angle going, Jimmy?
Just keep winding up.
Good, yeah. Yeah, my line's going under the boat, so just worrying about it. Uh-oh. Oh, have you got your fish there?
Yep, see the fish.
Oh, big one. That's got to be 120. Keep an eye on your mate, Jimmy. Don't let him.
Not a big fish, but they still fight, eh? Still give you a workout.
Oh! Yeah, what have you done?
Folks at home. And,
good lesson, eh? If you want something done, do it yourself.
I think you might go the way of Kosteki.
Jesus, mate.
Give me one more chance. Oh, yeah. I would have been there to help you, mate, but I was busy.
Here you go.
There you go, boys. They're the ones we like.
This fish would have been big enough to take the point for kingfish on a jig had it been caught by Jimmy or Aaron.
It's good fun. Look at this.
But it's not as big as the one that Team Spittle lost just moments ago. That could have also taken out kingfish on a bait. So with time almost up, two crucial points go begging for Team Spittle. And Dean takes out kingfish on a jig and kingfish on a bait.
Well, as you can see, the weather has finally come good. But unfortunately, I've just checked the official tournament timepiece and sorry, stop fishing, guys. Nothing else will count after this point. So, Dean.
Okay.
Yep, that's that. And if you could just tell us about your experience here for the last couple of days, I'm going to go and consult the official score sheet and I'll be back with you with the result.
Well, it's been a good couple of days actually. We've sort of experimented with a lot of different fish and different techniques, and it's been very enlightening to come out here and enjoy the
Yeah, sorry to interrupt there, Dean. I found this up the front of the boat and it's got your name on it. Maybe we had an inkling you were going to win, but the ultimate cup, it's the official presentation.
Wow, look at that.
Yeah. We haven't got some moe to spray anywhere, but we've got Lindau. It was on special at New World this week. But yeah, woohoo! Yeah. you could drink out of it, but it's just plastic and the lid's actually. It's all they had in Kerikeri. And I think I speak for not only myself and all the ITM crew, but everyone in New Zealand wishing you guys
the best of luck. Yeah. You've done us proud, and we know you're going to bring it home next time, mate.
Cheers, mate.
Thanks very much, mate.
Thank you. In the royal tradition, I should probably squirt Wooly down with a champagne. Oh.
That's a great one to go out on.
So Team Barker has taken the ultimate cup, reclaiming New Zealand's rightful place as the greatest nautical nation in the world, of all time, and in the universe.
Well, I hope you enjoyed this episode, but if you're left wanting more, it's a good thing we've got more. Right now, you can log on anytime to ultimatefishing.tv or download the Ultimate Fishing app, because we're out here all the time, just like we are now, fishing the depths, fishing the shallows, full episodes from all around the world, and fishing action and tips, and you can watch for free at ultimatefishing.tv.